Oyagala omukulu gugwenja olugobere n'ebijukize mu nyumba yo. Kankwanjulire Backing Montage Photo Studio. Fiba kafulumu kuba bifananyi. No color video. Olina wedding, birthday party, kuchala, nika, baby shower, photoshoot oba music shoot. Na buli kimu kyonna ky'oyagala. Fe tusobola okuwa ebijukize ebirungi. Eri ebirooto byo. Ate nno mwana wattu kusinteza omuntu wa bulijjo. Tusange bonnankula bikubitaala. Ku Prime Tower, Level 3, Room D04. Okumanya ebisingawo. Tukubire ku namba zino. Note musavu note biri. Emu note nya. Emu biri tano. Oba noti musavu tano tano. Satu emu emu. Musavu satu emu. Oba noti musavu musavu musavu. Noti biri satu. Nya noti tano. King Montage Photo Studio. Fitu sobulo kuwa bijukize bironji. Atenu mwana watu kusinti zo mtu wabulijo.
Hello friends, welcome BSCK to Love Media, where we spread love. If you're new to this channel, please subscribe and hit the notification button. Today we gonna look at Kiyza Warren Khafif's biography, age, and net worth. Warren Kiyza Bisiji Khafif was born on April 22, 1956 and's, known as Colonel Dr. Kiyza Bisiji, is a Ugandan physician, politician, and former military officer in the Uganda People's Defense Force. He served as the president of the Forum for Democratic Change, FDC, political party and was an unsuccessful candidate in Uganda's 2001, 2006, 2011, and 2016 presidential elections, losing all of them to the incumbent Yoweri Museveni, who has been president of Uganda since January 26, 1986. The results of the 2006 elections were contested in court, where court found massive rigging and disenfranchisement. He allowed an early internal FDC election for a successor president, which took place on November 24, 2012. Warren Kiyza Bisiji Khafif was born in Ruakabongo, Rukungiri Municipality, Rukungiri District, southwestern Uganda, on April 22, 1956. He attended Kanyazano Primary School and Barrera Junior School. The second born in a family of six, both his parents died before he finished primary school. His father was a policeman. He went to Kanyazano Primary School and Barrera Junior School for his primary school education. He later joined Kampala's Katant High School for his ordinary levels and then Kijizi High School in Kabul District for his advanced level education. Bisiji enrolled at Makerere University in 1975 and graduated with a degree in human medicine in 1980. While in the bush, he became Yoweri Museveni's personal physician. When the National Resistance Movement and Army, NRM/A, came to power in January 1986, he was appointed, at the age of 29, Minister of State for Internal Affairs. He later held the positions of Minister of State in the President's Office and National Political Commissar. In 1991, he became commanding officer of the Mechanized Regiment in Masaka, Central Uganda, and in 1993 was appointed the Army's Chief of Logistics and Engineering. On July 7, 1999, Bisiji married Winnie Byanyuma, a Ugandan Member of Parliament, in Ansambia, Kampala 1. Career. After graduating, Bisiji briefly worked at Malago National Hospital. He later went into exile in neighboring Kenya. While there, he applied to the medical board for registration to work as a doctor. After getting registered, he applied for a job at the AGA Khan Hospital, which he was given, and then started working as a doctor and later at Kenyatta National Hospital, both in the Kenyan capital, Nairobi, before joining Museveni's Rebel National Resistance Movement/Army, NRM/A, in 1982. Political life. In 1999, Bisiji wrote a document critical of the government, entitled An Insider's View of How the NRM Lost the Broad Base. The document accused the NRM of becoming a sectarian kleptocracy and a one-man dictatorship. Bisiji was charged before a court-martial for airing his views in the wrong forum. He later brokered a deal in 2000 in which the charges were dropped in exchange for an apology for publishing the document. In October 2000, Bisiji announced that he would run against Museveni in the 2001 elections. He retired from the Uganda People's Defense Forces in 2001, having attained the rank of colonel. During his campaign, Bisiji, who who was Museveni's strongest opponent, accused the government of widespread corruption and pushed for an end to Museveni's movement system, which he said had served its purpose as an instrument in Uganda's political transition to multi-party democracy. He lost the election, which was marred by claims of widespread vote rigging, violence, and coercion of voters. In March 2001, Besigye petitioned the Supreme Court to nullify the election results. A panel of five judges voted 5-0 that there had been cheating but decided 3-2 not to annul the elections. In June 2001, Besigye was briefly arrested and questioned by the police over allegations of treason. The government accused him of being behind a shadowy rebel group, the People's Redemption Army, PRA, allegedly based in the Democratic Republic of the Congo, DRC. Besigye's supporters said the government had fabricated the existence of the insurgents to harm his credibility among Ugandans and the international community. In August 2001, Besigye fled the country, citing persecution by the state. He said he was afraid for his life. He lived in South Africa for 4 years, during which time he continued to criticize Museveni's government. Besigye returned to Uganda on October 26, 2005, just in time to register as a voter in the 2006 elections. He was greeted by thousands and hit the campaign trail almost immediately, addressing throngs of supporters across the country. In November 2005, William Lacy Swing, the United Nations Special Envoy to the Great Lakes region, confirmed the existence of the PRA, naming it as one of the foreign, armed groups operating in the eastern DRC. Besigye's campaign came to an abrupt halt on November 14 when he was arrested on charges of treason and rape. The treason charges pertained to his alleged links to the PRA and the 20-year-old Northern Ugandan Lord's Resistance Army rebellion. The rape charge related to a 1997 accusation by the daughter of a deceased friend. His arrest sparked riots in Kampala and around the country. Museveni was accused of trumping up charges against his main rival in an attempt to discredit Besigye or even prevent him from standing in the election. Both the local and international community came down heavily against Museveni's administration, urging it to release Besigye on bail. The government reacted by banning all public rallies, demonstrations, assemblies, or seminars related to the trial of Besigye. It further barred the media from discussing the trial, threatening media houses with the revocation of their licenses should they refuse to heed the ban. On November 25, Uganda's High Court granted Besigye bail, but he was immediately sent back to jail on military charges of terrorism and the illegal possession of weapons. Besigye denied the charges against him and has argued that as a retiree from the armed forces, he should no longer be subject to an army court-martial. He was freed on bail by the High Court on January 6. Although the charges against him stand, Besigye continues to pursue his ambition to become the next president of Uganda. February 2006 elections. The general elections of 2006 saw FDC as the main opposition party and Besigye as the main challenger against Museveni for the presidency. He stood with Miria Kalyule Abbott, the first female presidential candidate for the Uganda People's Congress, UPC, Abed Bwanika, who stood as an independent, John Sabanakazido for Democratic Party, DP. Museveni was elected for another five-year tenure, having won 59% of the vote against Besigye's 37%. Besigye, who alleged fraud, rejected the result. The Supreme Court of Uganda later ruled that the election was marred by intimidation, violence, voter disenfranchisement, and other irregularities. However, the court voted 4-3 to uphold the results of the election too. February 2011 elections and aftermath. In the 2011 elections, Besigye for the third time in a row lost to his main challenger, the incumbent Yoweri Museveni, with a sharp decline from previous polls, failing to win in a single region. Though the election was lauded as one of the most free and fair in Ugandan history, citation needed, Besigye claimed that his challenger used intimidation and rigging to win a fourth term in office. Following his poor performance in the 2011 presidential elections, Besigye directed his party members elected to the 9th parliament to boycott it. This was rejected by the newly elected MPs, claiming that the election victory was out of their personal effort and not BCE's or the party, contributing to rising tensions within the FDC. Citation needed. BCE was arrested for a fourth time on April 28, during a walk-to-work protest over the high prices of food and fuel. He was sprayed with pepper spray 3 and dragged from his car by police 4. This was the catalyst for additional protests leading to riots across Kampala, in which at least 2 people were killed and 120 people wounded, leading to some 360 arrests. 5. Anti-homosexuality bill. BCE opposed the reintroduction of the Uganda Anti-Homosexuality Bill into the 9th Parliament of Uganda by backbench MP David Bahati. BCE's support of gay rights 6 was a contentious issue in Uganda, where homosexuality is already criminal under the Ugandan Penal Code, Gender References Amendment Act. 2012 arrest. BCE was arrested on October 1, 2012 after an attempt to make a speech to vendors in Kiseka Market in Kampala, Uganda. He was taken to a central police station in the city 7 earlier. Police had deployed heavily at BCE's home in a move to block him from traveling to town to hold his planned rally, but he managed to elude the security officials to a then undisclosed location until his arrest by police at the city market about an hour later. 7. 2016 election. In the 2016 elections, BCE again stood as the FDC presidential candidate, going up against other popular candidates Amama Mbabazi and Yoweri Museveni, the president of Uganda for 3 decades. BCE again lost to Museveni, receiving only 34% of the vote, while Museveni won 62%. 8. In the aftermath of this election, he urged his supporters to protest peacefully against the results, claiming that the electoral process had been rigged using intimidation of voters, imprisonment of opponents, sabotage of rallies, late delivery of election materials, delayed opening of election centers, vote falsification at undisclosed tally centers, and bribery, among other malpractices. 9-10. On May 11, 2016, he secretly swore himself in as president of Uganda, a day before the official swearing-in ceremony of President Yoweri Museveni. He was arrested by the Ugandan army moments into his swearing-in. 2021 elections. BCE opted not to run for presidency in the forthcoming election, saying he will lead the opposition in Plan B to cause change in the country. 11-12. He is going to ally himself with the main opponent of Museveni, Bobi Wine, to help him win the 2021 elections. 13. Thanks for watching Love Media. See you next time.
Oyagala omukulu gw'enjawulo gubeere n'ebijjukizo mu nnyumba yo, kankwanjulire Backing Montage Photo Studio. Ffe bakafulumu okkuba ebifaananyi n'okola vidiyo. Olina wedding, birthday party, kukyala, nika, baby shower, photoshoot oba music shoot, na buli kimu kyonna ky'oyagala, ffe tusobola okuwa ebijjukizo ebirungi eri ebirooto byo. Ate nno mwana wattu, ku ssente ez'omuntu wa bulijjo, tusange bonnankulabe ku bitaala ku Prime Tower, Level 3, Room D04. Okumanya ebisingawo, tukubire ku nnamba zino: Noti 7, Noti 2, emu Noti 4, emu 2 5. Oba noti 755 31 731 oba noti 777 noti 23 4 noti 5 King Montage Photo Studio. Fitu sobolo kuwa ebijjukizo ebirungi. Ate nno mwana wattu, ku ssente ez'omuntu wa bulijjo.